Hello, welcome back to our YouTube channels. In this video I will show you how to install WHMCS in direct admin account. So basically direct admin is the web hosting control panel, and recently cPanel has increased the pricing, so many people are using direct admin. So we will show you here how to set up WHMCS in direct admin. So this is the system requirement for the WHMCS. So you can visit on the WHMCS docs.whmcs.com/system_requirements. So your system, your direct admin should have these configurations. So stay tuned with us, subscribe our channel if you are the first time visiting in our channel, and if you have any question you comments and share the video, like the video. So now this is our direct admin control panel. Here we will upload WHMCS through the file manager. We have already downloaded the WHMCS latest version from the WHMCS, and after that in the root folder we have gone to domains. Under the domains we found our domain name, and under the domain name we have to see that there is the folder public_html. So we are going to uploading our WHMCS zip file under the public_html. So I have already downloaded WHMCS which is showing 66.8 MB, and after that I have uploaded this simple by clicking on the upload button from the direct admin. And when I upload it, it is just like we have to browse our upload file. We have to just upload this zip file by clicking open, and you have to just click on the upload button. So I have already uploaded this file. Now I'm closing this, and after that I have unzipped this file and it is installing in the root. So you are seeing this all the files and folder in the root version. Now we have visiting this website on the new tab of the browser. So the tmsoft.in. Now this is the first screen. It's showing welcome to WHMCS. Before you can begin using WHM, you need to perform the installation procedure. Click here to begin. So we just have to click here. It's checking the system configurations and user agreement. So we have to just click on agree button. So it's showing the system requirement check pass. We have seen that all the requirements which is needed by the WHMCS, it's successfully. So we have to start begin installation button. So it is asking our key, WHMCS key, and database localhost, database username, password and database name. So presently we don't have this. We have to create it from our direct admin dashboard. So let's see how to create the database also. This is the top MySQL icon. Create a new database. We have to just give in the name DB, and it's automatically taking the same as the database name, and the username will be the same. So give that site db, and the password is we have to generate it automatically. It is this password. I will reset it further. This is the password. No, it is not copying. And this is the database name. The username and password both are the same. We have to click create db. So now we have the license key also, which we have to copy from here. Paste the license key, database name dmsoft _ site db and dmsoft it is the password. It is our db name dmsoft _ site db, and we have to click continue. So now this is the administrator where we have to set up our admin. So we have to type their name, system admin, path email, password, share the same password here. I will update this password later on once it is finished. We are seeing here, you can install directly from the web server. Set up the daily clock. What we can do is just go to the file manager and install this direct admin is very uncomfortable to me. It's like it is not smooth, like similar to cPanel. This this is the directory which I have to delete. Again, I have to go to the dashboard and creating the cron. So I have to copy this path. I think this package is not available with the cron features. So now I have added the package that is allocated to this domain, and here I can see that it is the reseller panel. The cron job facilities so features is not enabled. So now I have saved this domain features. Save successfully. Now I'm going to my I'm refreshing this, and we'll see that the WHMCS cron features is available, and I have copied this cron path. And have you noticed that that is very easy and very simple to install the WHMCS in Direct Admin or any other place? Basically, I could not find any I could not face any error. Otherwise, it's very problematic to install the WHMCS. Cron feature is still not coming here. Okay, let it be. The cron is not added. We will add the cron later on. So now we have to just complete it our go to the admin area. We have to do basic other stuff settings. That is very important to do secure your WHMCS configuration setting. And this is recommended by the WHMCS. So I am not giving you some special information here. Admin and the password which I will copy here. And first task is to I will reset the password. The first important thing, I will rechange the admin path and resetting the password, resetting the file permission, and so on. There is many security warnings which I will show you recommended by the WHMCS after the login. That is the setup thing. I will disconnect it. It's asking for the logo, country and all that things. So first go to the help icon and go to the system health status. It will show you the complete warning and other thing. So first it's showing the required PHP function. So first we have to enable this escape shell command. There are traceable in your PHP ini. So this is regarding the hosting provider and require PHP extension for IMAP. So this is required for WHMCS, and PHP version it's showing 5.6 that is very old, outdated and insecure permission. The configuration file is writable, so I have also changed this. And website SSL is not configured, so we have to install the SSL certificate and recommended PHP extension XML RPC that is also not enabled, and they are showing the default and custom default path that is also default. So we have to improve this one by one, and that is the setup of the WHMCS in direct admin panel. That is very easy. If you like the video and you having any questions, so please comment this, share this video, subscribe our channel. Furthermore, we have come to the PHP version. Our native version is 5.6. We have improved it to 5.7 and a lot of other thing. We have found that like IMAP extension is required here. It's showing that IMAP extension that is not enabled, so we are doing this IMAP enable. And also we found that XML RPC warning, so we have to enable this XML RPC also. So this is the, I think, auto save set as current, so we have to set this feature as a current. So this is also we have to define set as current. Now we will refresh this page again and we see that whether it is working and reduce some warning or not. It has not taken any effect. We again refresh it. Okay. Okay, so our error is reduced to 1, and this is the 6th warning, insecure permissions. We will fix it also. We have to just we have to fix this by giving the permission this file. Currently the permission is 644. We have to give this 400. So we are removing this permission. We have saved this permission, and now we are going to come back on our WHMCS and we see there is no any error, only just one simple warning which is coming. Look good. So our error is 0 and warning is there, and warning is due to coming automatic updates if we require. So we have to add some settings and the custom default path. So I have to change this custom default path and this PHP version and website SSL. So one by one I will do this and you can do this also. Thank you for watching our video. Have a nice day. God bless you. Goodbye.